Hello.
Hello.
Wow. That's a lot of juice, Kaylin. Thank you. Welcome to another sold out show at the Velvet Net! The Velvet Net's a place where you can see and hear world-class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your very own living room. We give you a chance to get to know the musicians here and to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. This is a listening room. We had our acoustics designed by a protege of the Hollywood director, George Lucas, under his guidance to be the highest quality, unenhanced sound available today. And after winning 6 consecutive awards from Downbeat magazine for being one of the top 100 jazz clubs in the world, we celebrated 10 years this year. Yes. And we couldn't have done it without you, so thank you. We don't quite know what to do with ourselves. It's unusual that we're here on a Wednesday night. Sometimes I'm here, just standing in the room, looking around, hoping someone will walk in and keep me company. But it's rare that we have a full audience like you. And the reason is because there are some people that we want so much that we're willing to work on a Wednesday. And tonight's artist is one of those artists. So let me tell you a little bit about her before we get started. Molly Miller is an incredible guitarist. She is currently touring with Jason Mraz. She's been on the telly from time to time. She was on that Little Watch show by the Bachelorette franchise called Listen to Your Heart. Did anybody listen to your heart while watching that show, other than me? Okay, well, she was in that band. And she also has a PhD, side thing, a PhD from the prestigious USC. And she currently works full-time as the head of the chair of the guitar department over at the Los Angeles School of Music. And we are so happy to have her all the way from the West Coast here to play for us. But she didn't come by herself. Yes, she brought badassity with her. So let me tell you about her drummer. His name is Zach Albedo. He is not just a drummer, he's a writer, he's a podcaster, and he plays Sakai drums, which are very rare and very special. That gives you any idea about what you're going to hear. Sakai is a company that spun off from Yamaha and exiled themselves to a small island in Japan because they wanted to make drums that were of such high quality that Yamaha would not allow them to do so. So they went off on their own. Mad respect. On bass, one of the first female bassists I ever saw, Miss Jennifer Kandos. Miss Jennifer Kandos is truly, truly a legend already. And she has toured with many great people, including one of my favorite entertainers, Stevie Nicks. Yes. So all three of them are here on a Wednesday. Did I mention that it's Wednesday? To play for you. So I expect the type of applause that you would give if a badass band came to a 40-seat room and played for you on Wednesday. Put your hands together for the Molly Miller Trio!
all mashed into like one time period, so the years get blurry. But yeah, we came out just about a year ago, last summer, 2021. The first song was called Hasta Luego, and the last one was Spry. It is available on CD here today from my new record, St. George. I have a couple CDs for sale. So we're gonna be playing a mixture of songs tonight. Some originals off that record, some new originals that are unreleased that have, you know, we wrote over the past few years. And we just recorded actually a couple months ago, so I'm really excited to get them into the world, but that probably won't be till next year. And then some covers. So we're gonna play a cover right now, a song you'll probably recognize and our take on it.
Thank you.
an A section, I'd write a B section, I'd sit, write an A section, she'd sit, write a B section, and so forth. And we got a bunch of these sort of Western-esque songs, and that last one is one of them that was inspired from that time. And this is another lockdown song. This next one's called Blues to Greens. So the very beginning of the pandemic, I'm in LA, and I'm sure you know the smog there can be kind of grotesque. And no one was driving, no one was flying, and it also happened to be a ton of rain. So it was so beautiful. It was like simultaneously so sad because of what was going on in the world, but beautiful because all the colors were so vibrant. The sky was so blue, the greens were so green, the flowers were so bright. And this next song came from that time of the combination of like the sadness, but the beauty of giving, you know, Mother Earth a break for a second from us. So yeah, this is Blues to Greens. Thank you.
Hello.
Can you guys hear me okay when I'm just talking?
Yeah. You're a teacher, you can have
that. I know. I used to teach kids too, so I really am used to projecting. So that was one of the westerns, if you couldn't tell. We call it Two West. I'll do another one. This is the title track called St. George right now. And yeah, this is, you'll hear it. No story for this one. Some things I like to keep secrets. And you can decide what it means for you.
Thank you.
We're going to keep it a little country, a little cowboy, and do one of our songs called Hear It Callin'. Thank you. sign. So you probably noticed our songs are kind of eclectic. It's not necessarily just one genre, but a mix of different styles. And the group, you know, I feel like we have a common vision, and Jen has the same, of bringing back the instrumentals, because there was a time when there was instrumental songs, and that was it. It was like, that was the melody. There were these like 2-3 minute instrumental songs, and they were like hits and songs that people knew and sang. And so we're kind of reminiscent of that, plus all of our mixture of interests in music, but into one kind of cohesive sound. And so that's why we have a lot of these short songs where they're just a few minutes long, because we're kind of looking back at that, of these like early R&B songs, and you know, when you had to flip a record and you only had a couple minutes on each side. And that last song is kind of an example of that. It was like a quick song.
You don't remember
that.
She doesn't. I don't, I mean, I
haven't. She read about it somewhere.
I've been
in
told.
In school there.
Yeah. No, I had a Walkman. That was more about me. Records are back, and yeah.
So now let's play Giant Steps for 20 minutes.
We're going to close out with a half-hour version of Giant Steps. We're going to do another original. But yeah, thank you guys so much. This is so nice. It's my first time playing as Molly Poetry. Families from here, so I want to give a special thanks to the people who are hosting us and letting us stay in their home, his parents. So Yuna and Mark Newman, thank you guys for being here, and thank you for hosting. I would not have a place to sleep otherwise. So it's nice to be visiting and have a warm home to stay in. Okay, so this song is called Slow Burn to Nowhere. This is another original off of our record from last year, St. George. Thank you.
Thank you.
you guys so much for being here, and Tamara and everyone in the Velvet Note for having us. We're so happy to be here. Yeah.
Welcome back. Thank you.
most, how I express myself most often on the internet. And my Instagram handle is MoodyMill, MoodyMill. But Molly Miller, yeah, if you look me up, my website isn't fine, but come say hello. That's another way to find me.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. We make a little.
You guys heading out?
Testing, 1, 2, is this on? She needs to turn the music down. Uh-huh. Good evening. How you doing? Are we doing all right? The part of Mick Jagger tonight will be played by yours truly. Oh, you didn't know that this was it? No, okay. It's all right. You can. We were interested in what you were saying. It's okay.
Order a drink.
Order a drink. Yeah. I'm Bob Baker. I'm on the board of advisors here at the Velvet Note, which has been here for 10 years. Give it a big round of applause. 10 years of this. And Tamara asked me if I would introduce the person who y'all know who she is, so I don't know why I'm introducing anybody, but it's okay. I just want to say that I also have an alter ego. I'm the editor of a magazine called Jazz Guitar Today. And in that capacity, I interviewed all the top guitar players, you know, John McLaughlin, and not to drop names, but, you know, people like John McLaughlin and Robin Ford and, oh, I don't know, well, you know, everybody that's anybody, John Scofield and all those people. And so one of the things, I've been playing guitar since single digits, you know, 8, 9 years old. And one of the things in the magazine, and I won't tell you how I got it, it's kind of a long story, but I'm always looking for, you know, fresh approach to this genre. And there aren't a whole lot of them. But I will say lately there's been a lot more showing up. But I got turned on to Molly. And I said, you know, because people are always saying, oh, you got to hear this person, you got to hear that person. And I got to tell you, 90% of the time, it's a little rough, you know, because somebody's friend. I got turned on to Molly, and I went, holy shit. I was blown away because just the approach was so fresh, so cool, so alive, so just wonderful. And I said, well, I wonder if I can interview her for the magazine. And then I find out she's got all this education, which if you want to know more about that, you can Google her because I won't go through all that. But Dr. Molly Mellor, which blows me away. You look like my niece. God, are you 12, 14? How old are you?
21.
Okay. All right. At any rate, just
forever 21.
I'm with you. Yeah, I hear you. But just a wonderful approach to the music and the guitar, and not only with the feel, which is the most important thing. You've got the education, but that's only part of it. I talk about that like, you know, music is, as it's written, is like going. It's like going on a hike and just paying attention to the topographical map, and not really seeing what's out there. Like there's trees and there's birds and there's, you know, and creeks and you know all that. And so having this knowledge is great, but if you can't look out and see all that, which is what you bring to it, not only do you have that cerebral thing, but you got the feel and the touch. So, ladies and gentlemen, with that, I give you Dr. Molly Mellor.
some repeated information. So the first song was a cover. The last song we just did is a new song. It's unreleased. Just a couple months ago, we recorded a bunch of tunes, a lot of which were written during the pandemic period. And during that time, Jen was like, let's write a bunch of Westerns. I have the urge to write a record of Westerns. And I was all in. I had a pretty free schedule. I was like, let's go. So a lot of these songs, we'd write together. Jen would write a section, I'd write a section. So when we get an idea, we'd email it to each other and piece it together through the internet. And then it's so nice to finally be playing it together with human beings live and not on a computer for people. So thank you guys for being here. And that was that last song. It was coming from the Western inspired songs. We'll do one more of those right now. This one's called Head Out. But you'll hear a mixture of songs tonight. Some stuff off that unreleased record, some stuff off a record that came out last year called St. George, just a little over a year old, and some covers as well. I do have some CDs for sale, so come and say hello, and if you'd like one, I'm here. So here's a Head Out. Woo. Thank you. So in Los Angeles, we're not known for clean air. We're known for our smoggy skies, from all the traffic and all the human pollution. And in the beginning of the pandemic, no one was driving, everyone was at home. So there was no car pollution. And on top of that, there was this like a week of rain, which led to just the sky being so blue and the trees being so green and everything was so beautiful juxtaposed against this very sad and scary time. And so this song came from feelings about that. It's called Clues to Green. So it's a new one that is unreleased, but yeah, all cool thing now. Short, so we have a lot of them. So there's a lot of names to remember Some of them have similar names, and so yeah, that's why there could be some confusion. This song, how does that one go? What's that name? Because there's a lot of names. So this one is called "Hear It Calling." It's off St. George.
Thank you.
I normally have more pedals, but it's kind of nice to work with less. I am a believer in the fingers and doing more with less, so it's good. Just got a couple pedals versus my large pedal boy.
Thank you.
So we're going to play You Really Got a Hold on Me. And every time I hear this song or think of it, I'm reminded of watching Sesame Street as a kid. And there was a thing where Smokey Robinson sang this song, and there, like, it was a duet sort of, but there was a giant U. There was like a big puppet foam U with eyes and like a mouth. And the whole, like, Smokey was trying to sing the song, but the whole time he was singing the song, the U was like trying to grab onto him, because it was, "You really got a hold on me." Right? So like, it goes on for like 2 minutes, and like, at first the U is just like, "Hey Smokey, what's happening?" And Smokey's like singing like, "Hi U," and by the end of the song, Smokey's like running away from the U. Like, "No, I want to hold you."
So we all know what we're YouTubing tonight.
Yeah.
And one other fun fact, in that same era of music, Zach just found out he's going to be touring with the Broadway musical, Ain't Too Proud to Beg, the Temptations musical. So after hearing him tonight, I'm sure we're all going to try to go see that musical, because I'm sure it's going to be great. Here's You Really Got a Hold of Me. Thank you. Western songs. The song before that was an original off the last record called Whenever You Call. So it's the last set, but I was so touched. My little sister asked me to play it as she walked down the aisle just a few months ago. So now it has new special meaning for me. When she asked me, she was like, so we're either going to play your song or Till There Was You. And I was just kind of, I was like, you maybe have jobs. I got the job. This next one is called Slow Burn to Nowhere. It's also off the last record, St. George. Thank you. suggestions for covers. Jen gives me a lot of ideas, and this is Secret Love. Thank you.